Suppose you have a meter stick, that is, a stick whose length is 1 meter. You place 25 ants randomly on the stick. Now, once all ants are placed on the stick, each ant chooses a direction to walk in, so each ant walks either left or right. They all walk at the same speed, and whenever two ants meet, they switch their direction of travel. When an ant reaches the end of the stick, it falls off. It turns out that the ant in the middle of the line of ants has a disease. This ant doesn't necessarily have to be in the middle of the stick, it is just the 13th ant in the line of ants on the stick. Now, this ant will spread the disease to any other ant it meets, and any subsequent ant that catches the disease will also spread the disease to any ant it meets. So, with this scenario laid out, by the time all ants have fallen off the stick, what is the expected number of sick ants? Before we discuss the solution, let's let the scenario play out a couple of times to get a better feel for it. Okay, so let's take a look at a single interaction between two ants as they come into contact. Before these ants meet, they are moving towards each other, but as soon as they meet, they turn around and start moving away from each other. It can be difficult to predict what happens to the entire group of 25 ants using this model, but we can make a huge simplification. Instead of turning around when two ants meet, we can imagine them passing through each other. In this way, we will have two ants moving towards each other before they meet, and two ants moving away from each other after they meet. Now, you might be skeptical and argue that it took some time for the two ants to turn in the original scenario, while the two ants in our new model just keep walking. However, we really want to be thinking of these ants as single points on the meter stick that turn around instantaneously. So, technically, the ants would walk until they overlap, turn instantaneously, and keep walking, so our new model matches the old one again. But what happens when one of the ants is sick? If one ant is infected, then both of them will be infected after they meet each other. Thus, in our updated scenario, we can imagine that an ant passes along the sickness to any ant it passes through. Now, let's get back to the problem at hand. With our updated model of the ants, each ant keeps walking in the same direction, passing on the disease to every ant it passes through. Let's suppose the infected ant initially moves to the right. Then, it will infect all ants to its right that initially move to the left. However, the ants to its right that initially move to the right will never get infected, since all ants move at the same speed, meaning that the infected ant can never catch up to them. Now, once the ants to the right of the middle ant have been infected, they will move left, spreading the disease to any ant they encounter. If we do a little thinking, we'll notice that they will infect all the ants on the left side that initially move to the right. On the other hand, the ants on the left side that start moving to the left are too fast and will fall off the meter stick before they can ever get infected. Okay, so in the case where the infected ant starts moving to the right, we know which ants will be infected. But we can deduce that the same rules apply in the case where the infected ant moves to the left. Whichever way the infected ant turns, it will have 12 ants in its way. Since every ant chooses freely whether to turn left or right, we expect by symmetry that half of them turn left and the other half turn right. Since we're really interested in whether the ants point towards the center of the meter stick or not, we can say that we expect half of them to turn inward and half of them to turn outward. If the middle ant points right, the 6 left-facing ants to its right and the 6 right-facing ants to its left will eventually get infected. And if it points to the left, the 6 right-facing ants to its left and the 6 left-facing ants to its right will get infected. Therefore, the expected number of infected ants is 6 ants on the left, 6 ants on the right, plus the original infected ant, which makes 13. So there are an expected 13 ants that will be sick at the end. I hope you enjoyed working through this problem. If you like these types of puzzles, please consider subscribing to the Quant Quest. I will see you next time.